Rifle, muzzle devices, which one do you choose and why? And more specifically, what one do you choose for the rifle that you're setting up to do a bunch of training with? So say you're setting up a rifle to maybe take classes, you want to figure out how to, you know, get a proper mount on the gun, you want to be able to shoot it aggressively, etc. Straight up, I will tell you guys that my muzzle device of choice for that type of rifle, learning how to shoot rifle, is going to be the three-prong flash hider. Now, why would I choose a three-prong flash hider over a closed tine, over a muzzle brake, over a comp, etc.? So go ahead and try to explain this to you guys. The three-prong flash hider is not going to do anything for you in terms of, you know, like how the gun recoils, returning the gun to the place that you're trying to hit during recoil, etc. It's not going to do anything for you in terms of that type of stuff. And so this is going to make you more or less have to like pay close attention to the way that you mount the gun. Another thing that it's going to do is it's not like AR-15s are going to recoil a whole lot, but with these muzzle devices, you will see the gun recoil way more than it would with, say, a muzzle brake on the gun, kind of like this one here. It's big old, like, I think they call these rolling thunder brakes. So I used to use these on three-gun rifles back when I used to shoot some three-gun. These are very, very effective at essentially deleting recoil, right? With brakes like this, or, you know, two-port brakes, like the one that Surefire has, whatever, what you guys will notice is with these on here, you'll press the trigger and the gun basically just goes boom, and it doesn't move, right? It doesn't go anywhere. It doesn't give you any sort of input, which in my opinion can be a bad thing when you're trying to figure out how to mount the gun properly and shoot it aggressively. And so that's why I typically gravitate towards these three-prong flash hiders. I want to be able to, you know, shoot a duty rifle aggressively, and I don't want my skills to be attached to a specific piece of gear. And so, like, if you're setting up a rifle, you know, to take classes with and train with, I would recommend a duty style rifle with a duty style muzzle device, like these three prong flash hiders. I think these are great. If you learn how to mount a duty style rifle with this type of flash hider on there, and get a really good understanding of, you know, the types of pressures that you need on rifles to make them behave predictably, and then you pick up a gun that has one of these on it, you will be in straight shred mode because you will know how to mount the gun properly. Now, if you train with a rifle that has this style brake on it, and you are not used to duty style rifles with, you know, three-prong flash hiders on them, it is not going to go very well for you when you pick up a duty style rifle with like a three-prong flash hider, for example. It doesn't go that way. It only goes the other way. So if you get used to duty style rifles, chances are if you pick up a gamer rifle, you'll be able to shoot it pretty well, but not the other way around. A couple other muzzle devices out there real quick that are on the market are ones like these A2 style flash hiders where you have still flash hider, it's not a brake or anything, but you have ports on the top, and then on the bottom, it is closed, kind of like that. This is the Surefire closed tine flash hider. It works pretty well. What I noticed, though, with this style muzzle device is when you press the trigger, this kind of directs the muzzle down instead of just kind of lifting to a neutral position. It pushes the muzzle down, which I definitely don't like. It only gets worse when you use stuff like this, right? This is the Surefire War Comp. This might hurt some feelings for guys who like these things quite a bit. I personally think this style of muzzle device is pretty freaking hideous. Like when you have these on your rifle and you press the trigger, like you see the muzzle go down. If you know how to mount the rifle properly, not putting extra input into it, stuff like that, like you have a really good rifle mount. When you put this style muzzle device on, like you will see the muzzle dip down below the intended spot that you're aiming at. So I'm not a big fan of those at all. So in short, if you're setting up a rifle to train with specifically, you want to go take classes, you want to learn how to mount the rifle properly, I would recommend a duty style rifle without any sort of, you know, brake. I would put on a three-prong flash hider like this. would not do any sort of, you know, recoil delete type stuff like, you know, adjustable gas blocks and such. So anyway, three-prong flash hider is going to be the muzzle device of choice for me for the vast majority of what I do with rifles. I want to learn how to shoot a rifle very, very well. And I want to be able to pick up any rifle and be able to shred with it, not just a rifle that is super tricked out with muzzle devices, you know, that delete recoil and stuff. So that's my thoughts on muzzle devices. Go ahead, comment, like, subscribe, all that crap. If you have any questions, drop them in the comment box below. I will also add a link to my website. You can get on the website, click the register button, and basically see where I'm going to be throughout the year. I'm actually scheduling classes for next year. So this year and next year, some of next year are up there. So if you want to get in on class, get some training, go ahead and check that out. We'll see you guys on the range.